has criticised Donald Trump's handling of the coronavirus crisis, saying the sacrifices people have made shouldn't be wasted by a president who ignores the science.
The country's top infectious disease expert, Anthony Fauci, has warned that the infection rate could more than double. Our North American correspondent Peter Bowes has the story.
A nation on edge again. The coronavirus outbreak is worse than ever. The southern and western states of Florida, Arizona, Texas, and California account for about half of all new cases. Some hospitals are running out of intensive care beds, and experts are warning of a looming catastrophe if the outbreak isn't brought under control. Testifying to a Senate committee on the effort to reopen schools and businesses, the US government's leading expert on the virus, Dr. Anthony Fauci, said he feared the situation could get a lot worse.
We are now having 40 plus thousand new cases a day. I would not be surprised if we go up to 100,000 a day if this does not turn around.
Stepping up his campaign for the presidency, Joe Biden has launched a blistering attack on Donald Trump's handling of the pandemic.
Your promises and predictions and wishful thinking pulled out of thin air are not only doing the country no good, making them lose even more faith in their government. America knows this crisis isn't behind us, even if you don't.
Without responding directly to the former vice president, Mr. Trump once again blamed China. With no end in sight to the COVID crisis and a holiday weekend approaching, the worst affected states are now renewing some lockdown measures. In Texas, the closure of bars has provoked a backlash from some, but weary acceptance from others.
It's obviously spreading in bars, so if we gotta shut it down for the better of the community, that's what we gotta do.
Right now, we're the first guys to get shut down, the last to open. And they're not hearing us. And if we've got to scream it as loud as can be, we want to be heard.
In California, the beaches have been shut down again, and people urged to stay at home. There'll be little to celebrate this Independence Day. Peter Bowes, BBC News, Los Angeles.
A new treatment for cystic fibrosis, described as truly life-changing, is being made available for NHS patients in England. Experts say that 9 out of 10 people with the life-limiting